In this video, we want to demonstrate how to hide, unhide, and how to delete all drawing tools at once, how to lock drawings, and how to move tools into different layers within Track and Trade. I'm doing this demonstration in the stocks version of Track and Trade, but these features are exactly the same whether using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I've already drawn four different tools on the screen. Notice that two of them are circles, two of them are squares. This is important because when we right-click on a tool, this gives us information about this particular tool. So for example, if we have it selected, you'll notice that it has the handles. When I right-click it, we're going to be able to use the different features in the right-click menu. The first one I want to talk about is the Send to Back. Now this tool, let's say that we draw it over the top of, and let's actually do a new drawing, let's draw it over the top of the square. This drawing is on top of the square, but let's say that we're in a situation where we want to move the square, but we can't get to it over here. We want to get to the square by moving through the circle. When we select, if we left click, we are only getting access to the circle. So we might want to put the circle in back of the square, and simply by right clicking on the circle, saying send to back, it puts it on a different layer. Now when you click, you'll notice that the handles switch to the square. If you want to put it behind the circle, you simply say send to back, and now when we click, we have access to the circle. So it's just putting one drawing on top of the other. If you think about it as two pieces of paper, one's laying on top of the other piece of paper, and we're trying to access the piece of paper that's underneath that top paper. So that is send to back, allowing us to manipulate the different tools in different layers. The next thing I want to talk about is the properties. The properties tab, of course, when we right click that, that brings up the preferences for that particular tool. The next one is the lock. Oftentimes we'll get into a situation where we like to lock down an individual tool. So we can lock that tool and now we can't move it. It won't move, and it no matter what we do, we cannot move that tool. Okay, that tool is locked down. So that's how we lock down different drawing tools. The next feature I want to talk about is the delete key, and of course that's the same in every tool. We can go ahead and just hit the delete key, and that's going to delete the individual drawing. I'm going to draw that tool back in there. And of course, to delete the key, we can also hit the delete key on the keyboard, and that'll delete it as well, as long as the handles are selected. The next feature I want to talk about is delete all tools. Now you'll notice that when I right click on here, I get a delete all tools, but this is for circles only because we're only talking about circle tools. You'll notice I have a circle, a square, a circle, and a square. So if I right click and say delete all tools, it's only going to delete all of the circle tools, not all of the tools on the screen in their entirety. So if I draw my circles back in, and then I say I want to delete all the tools, not just the circle tools, I have to come to the right click menu, which is just on the open chart and not on any individual tool, and down here I can say delete drawing tools. But before that, I can come in, and I've got one step prior to deleting the tool, I can just say show drawing tools or hide drawing tools. Now if I unselect this show drawing tools, that's going to hide all the drawing tools that are on the screen universally. If I right click and bring that menu back up, you'll notice I can show the drawing tools once again. If I would like to delete all the tools on the chart, very simply all I have to do is say delete drawing tools from the right click menu on the chart, and this will delete all of the tools, not just the individual tool styles.